Cardi B is mad at Congress people because they're speaking about her WAP performance once again. Like, they're still talking about the WAP shit. So let me play that clip for you guys real quick.
I have received complaints in my office, and rightfully so, about Cardi B and the Grammys. They wonder why we are paying the FCC if they feel that this should be in living rooms across the nation. I realize that Kamala Harris has used her fame to promote this performer, but I assure the FCC that millions of Americans would view her performance as inconsistent with basic decency. Wake up, FCC, and begin to do your job. The moral decline of America is partly due to your utter complacency.
So Cardi B, you know, she's a, you know, it's a, been a trying week, Derek Chauvin, and, you know, the unfortunate tragedy of Makia Bryant happens. That's sad, of course, 15-year-old kids being, you know what I'm saying, regardless of what they did, it's still a sad situation. This is what state reps want to come up here and talk about. I don't know how they set up, like, the Congress. I don't know how they, how their meetings are set up. I don't know if these things are drawn out in advance. I know they randomly have certain meetings, not meetings, they're called something, hearings, randomly. Well, this person came to hear about this, or this person's coming here to talk about this. Like, student loan, like, when you see Hasan Minhaj talking about Lil Uzi Vert having to pay for kids' college, and why isn't the government helping to pay for kids' college, but these rappers aren't. That's, like, shit like that. So, I mean, is he at fault? No, because people see him, they'll, you know what I'm saying? This is my thing. People will see things, and they'll take it a certain way. I don't think that they're necessarily like, fuck the George Floyd shit, fuck the Derek Chauvin shit. We don't care about that shit. We're going to talk about Cardi B. But as a state rep, if a representative of my district sends me a letter that they want me to present to Congress, that's just what I got to do. Like, hey, they don't, FCC, they want to know why the FEC is allowing you to be dancing, hump and make the stallion on stage. So that's what I'm going to bring, because I have to represent my constituents and I want to get reelected once again. But Cardi B is like a political punching bag at this point. Like, anything Cardi B does, the people on the right are going to destroy it for it. And I mean, it's just because certain people get used for certain things, right? Like I said, Candace Owens, like, she may believe like conservative shit, great, that's fine, I don't really care. Everybody can believe whatever they want to believe. I can have conversations with everybody, I don't care. But like, you see how she gets used in the machine and the cog of right-wing media, right? Like, anybody can see it. Like, a black issue comes up, she's going to be on Tucker. She's going to be on this. She's going to be brought on every news station, every radio show to talk about this. They're not bringing you on to talk about the economic struggles of America. They're not bringing on you to talk about foreign policy. They're not bringing you on to talk about China. They're not bringing you on to talk about education. Unless it's a black thing, they're not bringing you on. So, like, in that cog, in that machine, like, that's what your position is. Cardi B's position is, Cardi B is what's wrong. Like, she's the example of what's wrong in everyday culture, right? That's what Cardi B is. Cardi B is used by the right, not even just the right, just people in general who don't like, you know, like the sexualization, the over whatever thing, they don't like all that. She is used for that. So whenever something goes wrong, whenever something is looked at, deemed immoral, her, even like at one point when it was like the Sukiyana chick, like, those people are used for that reason. But, you know, hey, that's the way you want to be. That's how you're going to be. Like, if you want to be sexual and be like a mainstream superstar, that's the price you got to pay to live in that life, right? So,